Hello TaleForgers, in this video we'll focus on the loading screen implementation, which will complete the scene management part. We'll learn interesting mechanisms for async code execution, especially waiting for the ECS subscene to load, so let's dive in and see how to implement this. First of all, I want to install UniTask, which provides efficient allocation async await integration for Unity. And thanks to UniTask, we can await on the async operation, which is really great, so I added a link to the package in the video description. So let's scroll down and select Getting Started section, click on the UPM package and copy Git reference. Okay, go back to Unity and select Window, Package Manager. Then click on the plus icon and select Add Package from Git URL. Paste the copied link and press Add button. Now we need to wait for compilation process to finish. Let's start by extending the level system logic. First, we'll add a new public const int animation time in milliseconds parameter and set it to 1000. We will need it to wait for async operations as well as animations on the loading screen scene. So let's add new private async UniTask method, LoadingScreen, which will have one parameter, bool is enabled. If this parameter is set to true, we need to await on the load scene async, LoadingScreen. We'll add LoadingScreen to the scene type later in the video. Of course, load scene mode additive. Also, important note, we can wait for the async operation thanks to the UniTask package. Without this package, we have to write some code to handle await. Then we want to wait for animation to finish, so let's call await unitask.delay animation time in milliseconds. And the last thing in this method, if isEnable is equal to false, then we unload the loading screen scene. Next, let's change void load scene to async void load scene because we want to wait for the loading screen as well as other load or unload operations and add await loading screen true so we start loading screen process. Also, let's add await to the unload scene async and load sync async. Finally, call await loading screen false, so we disable loading screen panel. In the load next level method, let's add async keyword and a new parameter. Bool is loading screen with the default value set to true. Now write if is loading screen, await loading screen, true. Add await to the unload previous level and load next subscene, which we will change in a moment. At the end, call await loading screen false. Okay, it is time to modify unload previous level, so let's change code signature to async UniTask. We need to wait for the ECS subscene to be unloaded, so I found in the documentation one useful for us method in the scene system, isSceneLoaded. So I can write while scene system isSceneLoaded word.defaultGameObjectInjectionWord.unmanage current entity scene. Await UniTask yield. This is similar to calling yield return null or yield return new wait for end of frame in the coroutines. Great, so we have ECS code to wait for the subscene to unload. Next, let's change the load next subscene from void to the async UniTask. I can copy and paste the code from unload. The only difference is the sign, because in the load case we need to use negation. And that's it. Last thing to do, let's add false to the load next level method in the onSceneLoaded. Okay, it is time to modify scene type because we need to add loading screen type. Before we move on, I would like to invite you to support us on the Patreon. Even a small contribution will help to develop the channel and the quality of the content present. Link in the description. Okay, let's back to the code and create new script. Loading Screen Animation Controller. It is mono behavior class, which will be responsible for simple fade animation on the UI. So let's add two serialized fields, image and text. Of course, add necessary usings. Also, create private level system variable, because we need to react on the level loaded, subscene loaded, or scene loaded events. Level system is equal to the word.defaultGameObjectInjection word.getExistingSystemManageLevelSystem. Then subscribe to the LevelSystem.LevelLoaded event to the onLevelLoaded method. Also, let's subscribe to the SceneManager.SceneLoaded to the onSceneLoaded method. I want to use the crossfade alpha, which based on the canvas renderer alpha, so let's set alpha to 0 in the onEnable, both for text and image. Then let's call fade method with parameter 1. Of course, don't forget to add onDisable and unsubscribe from events. Okay, it's time to create private void onSceneLoaded scene loadSceneMode scene mode method. If scene.buildIndex equals to the loading screen, then we can early return. But otherwise, we want to set fade to 0 because the other scene is loaded and ready to play. Next, let's create private void onLevelLoaded, so when subscene loads, we want to fade to 0. And finally, let's implement fade method. It is private void function with float fade value parameter. Inside it, let's write text.crossFadeAlpha fade value, LevelSystem.AnimationTimeInMilliseconds divided by 1000, false. The first parameter is responsible for setting the alpha, seconds is the duration, and the last one is a parameter that ignores the time scale. That's why I pass false. I don't want to ignore time scale. Let's write same code for the image. Let's go to the Unity editor, wait for the compilation to finish, then copy and paste the menu scene. Rename it to loading screen and open the scene. Inside it, let's delete everything except canvas. In the content, let's add three things: background, image, and text. Of course, set everything as you like. I will leave some simple message and will fast forward this process. The most important part for us is to correctly add new loading screen animation controller and drag references to text and image, because we want to animate it during loading, even if it is simple fade. Now, let's open build settings and add our newly created scene, loading screen. Last thing to do, let's change sort order to 1000. Because we want to overlay everything with the loading screen. Okay, let's test the behavior. I suggest we test the full game loop, so we can see how it works. Also, watch the scenes that load and unload in the hierarchy tab. As you can see, everything is working correctly and we have implemented simple loading screen. Thank you for your time. I'm glad you are with us and our community is growing. See you soon in the next video.